Dear students, good morning all of you. Today once again I am here with a new video, and in this video we will discuss something more about HTML. First of all, I would like to welcome you all in this new video, and I would like to suggest you that in the previous video we have discussed the introductions of HTML and few more important things like requirements about text editor and web browser. Now this is the next video, and in this video we will discuss about elements and tags. Elements or tag in HTML. A little bit, a brief explanation we have already done yesterday in the previous video, and today in this video we will discuss something more about the elements or tags. Once again I would like to give you the short introduction of tag or element. You can simply say that tags are just similar to the commands, options or orders that we follow to perform an activity in any other kind of program. Similarly, that all kind of commands, options, actions, activities in this program is known as elements or tag. Mainly there are two types of tags of HTML, which are types of element / tags. There are mainly two types of tags or elements in HTML, that are container tags or elements and empty tags or elements. Once again I tell you that there are mainly two types of tags in HTML. One is known as container tag and another one is known as empty tag. Yesterday I have told you, means in the previous video I have told you that tags are the word, letter or sentence that can be kept inside a special kind of symbol, that is a left angle bracket and a right angle bracket. So here I would like to give you some example before we proceed for the container tag and empty tag. The text or word that we keep into the left angle bracket and right angle bracket, that is known as tag. It is the tag, or you can say it is the element. Now you can see that these type of tag have two types of positions, or in few of the text, few of the word or letter have only one positions. The tags which have two types of position, two positions, a start and end, is known as container tag, and the tag which have only a starting, or you can say only one tag, is known as empty tag. Let's we have some example of empty tag as well as container tag. In the container tag we can put HTML dot dot dot, then again HTML. This way you can see this is the beginning or starting tag, and this is closing and ending tag. So the tag which have these both of the positions are known as container tag. You can see here, when you will use HTML tag or HTML programming code will be written in this way. This will be as the opening tag and this will be as the closing tag, and tag in which these both positions will be available, these both positions will be used. Such all tags will be known as container tags, and the tags which have only one position. Let's we have an example. You can see here, like br tag, it stands for break. It have only one position, no any other position is used. You can now categorize the differences between the container tag and empty tag here. You can see the beginning tag that is simply enclosed into the left angle bracket and right angle bracket, but the ending tag is enclosed into left angle bracket and right angle bracket including the backward slash, or you can say including the slash. Here you can see that there is only one tag, only one position that is enclosed into left angle bracket and right angle bracket. So this way you can categorize, you can understand that in container tags are the tags which have both positions are starting as well as ending, and empty tags have only one position that is a starting as well as ending. You can say anyone you can say that it is only a starting, no ending tag is there. You can see here ending tag have a slash before the text or word, but the opening tag have no slash before the word or text. So this way you can find the definition. This way you can understand the differences between container tag and empty tag. Now let's proceed further. For the HTML programming, few of the tags are basically used. Without that, no work can be done. That are known as the basic tags. That are known as the basic tags or basic elements, which are used in each and every programming code. Whether that the programming code is basic or whether that the web page is basic or dynamic, but for each and every programming code, for each and every HTML code for the web page, that tags are used. That tags are HTML, head, body, and title and body. These are the four basic tags which are used in each and every web page or for each and every HTML code. So these all four tags are known as basic tags. Here you can see these all are the example of container tag. So you can say that these all have two positions, like HTML this way and head this way. After this you can see title this way, and we use body closing tag this way. So I hope you understood that these all are the basic tags, and all the basic tags of HTML are the example of container tag. In the elements, in the empty tags, we will discuss something more about other in the further video. Today in this video, we have only understood these all the things. And here I would like to wind up the video. Here I would like to end the class. And before I end the class, I would like to give you the summary. Today in this video, we have covered HTML elements, oblique tags. In the HTML elements, oblique tags, we have covered introductions and types of elements. Types of elements, we have covered container tag and empty tag. We have understood our definition of container tag and empty tag as well as examples. So with examples, we have understood container tag as well as empty tag. With this word, I would like to wind up the speech today. I would like to wind up the class today. Hopefully you all are well. Be safe and secure at your home. Have a good day.